You know, when you think about the greatest sporting things ever, you got, you know, the Ice Bowl, the Miracle on Ice, you know, Rocky, Rocky IV, Rocky V, you know, Doug Creed, you know, that was pretty cool too.
We didn't have stats. We didn't have big money. You know what we did have, kid? A whole lot of hot and a whole lot of free time too.
Yeah, when I look back at those times playing Madden, I just think, was there anything else I should have been doing?
The year 2017. The country's mood, pissy.
Donald J. Trump is now president of the United States.
An election that divided America. High cost of living, war in Syria, Russians being kind of mean to us again. Americans needed a pick-me-up.
You know, the world was kind of fucked back then. Money was tight. As we're going to town home, unemployment was holding steady at 100%. And Kevin wasn't doing the fucking dishes. Everyone was fucking pissed.
Those were troublesome times. We were Bernie bros, so when he lost, we kind of gave up on everything, yeah?
But sometimes, when all is bleak, the thrill of competition is all it takes to rise out of the darkness. It was the Jabroni League. Four renegade roommates determined to ignore all their problems and bring hope back to the world through fake sport. There was Kevin, the renegade. Lyle, the renegade. Steve, the renegade. And Chaz, the renegade. Together, they were renegades, creating some of the most ridiculous matchups in Madden history.
It was a fucking game with 20 fucking picks. Unfucking believable.
We had quarterbacks throwing for 500 yards and still had a QB rating of less than 60. I mean, we were punting. Fuck that. We were going for it on fourth down every single time.
You know, we actually used to play Halo quite often, but ever since Steve downloaded Madden, Madden sort of outshone Halo. We were playing Madden all the time. What does that tell you?
As the season went on, passions flared, as did tempers.
Oh yeah, dude. The rivalry.
So, you want to tell me about the rivalry?
Rivalry? Ain't no fucking rivalry, alright? Is it with Steve? No, I was the one who was fucking winning every time. You know, the game fucked me, you know? This game, there ain't no rival, okay? Ain't no fucking rivalry.
You got challenged by a rivalry, huh? Bad idea.
The rivalry betwixt Chaz and Steve was fierce.
Fuck you.
We come through like King Kong. Godzilla, Michael Jackson, tonight is thriller.
Chaz would always blame the game, but never himself.
Okay, so Madden changed the fucking field goal system, alright? It was one way, all right, for like 20 years, and then they fucking change it. I go and I, you know, I master it, and then they go back to the old way, and it's fucking bullshit, okay? It's fucking bullshit.
The season-long animosity betwixt Chaz and Steve came to a head at the Jabroni Bowl. The winner was to take home the Jabaloon. A hard-fought game. It wasn't clear who would win from the start, all the way to the end.
I had the ball on the 4-yard line. Fourth down. Game on the fucking line.
Play a call like this, certainly tougher to make it a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down.
Hoisting that javelin? No, there's no better feeling. No better feeling. Yeah! I'd like to thank, first and foremost, my father, my mother, all the same person, Roger Goodell. Thank you, Roger.
With Steve as the champion and hours of gut-wrenching close games, the season had ended.
Like, Steve definitely won the javelin, but, I still believe that at the end of the day, all four of us, you know, Steve, Chaz, myself, Lyle, Kevin, I feel like we all learned a lot of lessons about life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, which was playing Madden all the time, and brothership.
Yeah, clearly I'm not satisfied. I mean, I came in fourth and you guys barely interviewed me for this thing. Not to mention, I can't even get a chair. I'm just sitting on the floor in the corner of this room. But at the end of the day, I mean, it was a great season of football. A great goddamn season of football.
Wow. Talking about the Jabroni Bowl again? Well, it takes me back, man. Takes me back.
It has been 2 weeks since the conclusion of the Jabroni Bowl. While many things are the same here, the warriors of the virtual gridiron are not. Finger cramps, wrist pain, and continuing unemployment have taken their toll. Most tragically of all, Kevin has died.
You know, I know it's only been 2 weeks, but I still feel like I can reach out and say, like, Kevin, man, you know, let's smoke and play a game of Madden. Or like, hey, dude, Kevin, let's toke one up and play some Madden, bro. It's been really fucking hot. Really fucking hot. Oh, I'm sorry. I had something in my fucking eye. Oh. It sucked. And the rent's gone up, so, you know, it sucked too. That was probably worse.
Some people like to look back at what happened and say, hey, if Kevin had gotten more exercise and eaten less Doritos, he wouldn't have gotten a heart attack. But I don't care what any shape any of us are in. We'd do it all again. So what's that tell you?
You know, a lot of people out there look at us and go, oh, it's just a game. But I'd like to think it's a lot more than that. I'd like to think that we might have inspired a lot of people you know, the thriller of Thursday when I lost to Chaz 55-57. That was tight. And, you know, I bet Russia saw that. And they were probably like, maybe let's, like, do world peace. You know what I mean?
You really think that by playing Madden, you had a direct impact on actual world peace?
Yeah. Maybe. Maybe.
Back at the line after that catch for a first down.